देवी भागवतम बुक 5 चैप्टर 26 ऑन द किलिंग ऑफ चंडा एंड मुंडा व्यासा सेड ओ किंग दस ऑर्डर्ड द टू स्ट्रांग वॉरियर्स चंडा एंड मुंडा हरीडली वेंट टू द बैटल अकॉम्पनीड बाय अ वास्ट आर्मी देयर दे सॉ द देवी इंटेंट ऑन डूइंग गुड टू द गॉड्स देन दे बिगैन टू एड्रेस हर इन कंसिलियेटरी वर्ड्स ओ लेडी यू आर नॉट नोन You do not know that the extraordinary strong Shumbha and Nishumbha, the lords of the Daityas, have crushed down the Devas and vanquished Indra and have been intoxicated with their victory. O Fire One, thou art alone. Only Kalika and thy lion are with thee. It is thy foolishness that you are desirous to conquer Shumbha, who is endowed with all power. I think there is no advisor to you, man or nor woman. The Devas have sent thee here simply for thy destruction. Think, O delicate one, over the powers of yours as well as those of your enemy. Vainly you boast of your having 18 hands. Before the great warrior Shumbha, the conqueror of the Devas, many hands and many weapons will be useless. They will prove mere burdens. So thou fulfill what reigns in the heart of Shumbha, the destroyer of the legs and the uprooter of the teeth of Airavata elephant. Vain is thy boast. O beloved, follow my sweet words. They will do good to thee. O large-eyed one, they will destroy thy pains and give thee bliss. Those actions that lead to pain are to be avoided by the wise, and those that bring in happiness are to be served by the pandits. Versed in the Shastras. O sweet speaking one, thou art clever. Look at the great strength of Shumbha with thy eyes. He has enhanced his glory by crushing down the Devas. And if thou thinkest the gods superior, that is false. For the wise men do not rely on mere guess full of doubt. They believe what they actually see. Shumbha, hard to be conquered in battles, is the great enemy of the gods. They have been crushed down by him and have therefore sent thee here. O sweet smiling one, thou hast been deceived by their sweet words. They, prompted by their selfish ends, have sent you here simply to give thee trouble. The friends that come with certain business and selfish ends are to be rejected. Friends out of religious motives are only to be sought for refuge. Verily, I tell thee that the gods are terribly selfish. Therefore, do serve Shumbha, the conqueror of Indra and the lord of the three worlds. He is a hero, beautiful, lovely, cunning, and thoroughly expert in the science of love. Though thou wilt get the prosperity of all the worlds by the mere command of Shumbha, therefore, make a firm resolve and serve that splendid husband, Shumbha. Vyasa said, O King, the universal mother, hearing the words of Chanda, spoke with a voice deep as thunder. O Boor, why do you use false, deceitful words? Fly away just now. Why shall I make Shumbha my husband, disregarding Hari, Hara, and other Devas? O you, a veritable fool, I have no necessity for my lord. I have got nothing to do with my lord. I myself am the lord of all the beings, and I preserve this whole universe with all the lords and being therein. Note this, in ancient times I saw thousands and thousands of Shumbha and Nishumbha, and I slew them all. I sent hundreds and hundreds of daityas and demons to the realm of death. Before me, the hosts of Devas were destroyed in yugas after yugas. Today the Daityas again will go unto destruction. The time has come to destroy the Daityas. Why then are you struggling in vain with your followers for your lives? Fight now and keep the dharma of the warriors. Death is inevitable. Thinking thus, the high-souled ones should keep their name, fame, and respect. What business have you to do with Shumbha and Nishumbha? Follow the warrior's dharma and go to heavens, the abode of the gods. Shumbha, Nishumbha, and your friends and followers all will follow you and will come here, no doubt. O stupid one, I will put an end to all the Danavas today. Therefore, cast aside your weakness and go on fight. I will slay you and your brother just now. Next, I will kill the proud Raktabija, Nishumbha, Shumbha and the other Danavas in the battlefield and will then go to my desired place. Now remain here if you like or fly away quickly. You have been fed in vain because you fear to fight. What use is there now in using sweet words like a weak and distressed man? Well, take up your arms now and fight. Vyasa said, O King, Chanda and Munda, elated with pride, got excited at the Devi's words, became angry and made a violent noise with their bowstrings. The Devi too blew her conch shell so loudly that the 10 quarters of the sky reverberated. In the meanwhile, the powerful lion became very angry and roared loudly. Hearing that sound, Indra and other Devas, the Munis, Yakshas, Siddhas and Kinnaras became all very glad. A dreadful fight then ensued between Chandika and Chanda with arrows, axes and other weapons, causing terror to the weak. Then Chandika Devi became very wrathful and cut off to pieces all the arrows shot by Chanda and then hurled arrows serpent-like on him. Then the sky over the battleground seemed to be overcast with arrows, just as the clouds get covered over with locusts, dreadful to the cultivators. In the meanwhile, Munda, exceedingly terrible, came up to the field, taking with him his army, and becoming impatient with anger, began to shoot arrows. Seeing that multitude of arrows, Ambika got very angry. Out of her frowny look, her eyebrows became crooked, her face became black, and her eyes turned red like kadali flowers. At this time, suddenly came out of her forehead Kali, wearing the tiger's skin, cruel, covering her body with elephant's skin, wearing a garland of skulls, terrible, with a belly like a well dried up, mouth wide open, with a wide waist, lip hanging loosely, with axe, noose, Shiva's weapon in her hands. She looked very terrible, like the night of dissolution. She began to lick frequently and forcibly, dashed into the Danava army and began to destroy it. She angrily began to take the powerful Danavas by her arms and, pouring them into her mouth, crushed them with her teeth, taking the elephants with belly. With bells by her own power in her hands, she put them all into her mouth and swallowed them all with their riders and began to laugh hoarsely. Thus camels, horses and charioteers with chariots all she put into her mouth and began to chew them all grimly. O King, seeing that the forces were being thus destroyed, the two great warriors Chanda and Munda began to shoot arrows after arrows without intermission and covered the Devi with them. Chanda hurled the Sudarshana like disc, lustrous like the sun, with great force against Devi and frequently shouted thundering cries. Seeing him roaring and lustrous disc coming together her like another sun, she shot at him arrows sharpened on stones, so that the warrior Chanda became overpowered by them and lay down senseless on the ground. The powerful Munda, seeing his brother unconscious, became very much distressed with grief, but he got angry and began to shoot arrows immediately on the Devi. Chandika Devi hurled the weapon named Isika and thus cut off to pieces all the dreadful arrows of Munda in a moment and shot Ardhachandra arrow at him. With this arrow, the powerful Asura was deprived of his pride and made to lie down unconscious on the earth. Munda thus lying on the ground, a great uproar arose amidst the army of the Danavas, and the Devas became delighted in the sky. In the meanwhile, Chanda became conscious and, taking a very heavy club, hurled it violently on the right hand of Kalika. Kalika rendered that blow useless and instantly tied down that Asura by her Pasa weapon purified by mantras. Munda again rose up and, seeing his brother in that fastened condition, came to the front well armored and with an exceedingly strong weapon called Shakti. Seeing the Asura coming, she instantly fastened him down like his brother. Taking the powerful Chanda and Munda like hares and laughing wildly, Kali went to Ambika and said, I have brought the two beasts very auspicious as offering in this sacrificial war. Kindly accept these. Seeing the two Danavas brought as if they were the two wolves, Ambika told her sweetly, O thou fond of war, thou art very wise. So do not commit the act of envy, nor does leave them. Think over the purport of my words and know that it is thy duty to bring the Devi's work to a successful issue. Vyasa said, O king, hearing thus the words of Ambika, Kalika spoke to her again. In this war sacrifice, there is this axe which is like a sacrificial post. I will offer these two as victims to thy sacrifice. Thus no act of envy will be committed. Thus saying, the Kalika Devi cut off their heads with great force and gladly drank their blood. Thus seeing the two Asuras killed, Ambika said gladly, that thou hast done the service to the gods. So I will give thee an excellent boon. O Kalika, as thou hast killed Chanda and Munda, henceforth thou will be renowned in this world as Chamunda. Here ends the 26th chapter of the 5th book on the killing of Chanda and Munda in Srimad Devi Bhagavatam, the Mahapuranam of 18,000 verses by Maharishi Veda Vyasa. Srimatre Namaha.